My name is Brian Allen, and I'm a freelance illustrator. With my brother Keith Allen and my grandmother Joanne DeFior, we created the A Day in Rehoboth Beach pop-up book. I'd like to run you through real quick some techniques and equipment that I use to illustrate the pop-up book. When I started my career, I was trained in traditional illustration, basically pencil on paper, pen on paper. Then I would scan the artwork and usually color it in the computer. About 4 years ago, I switched over to 100% digital workflow. What allowed me to do that was equipment by Wacom. This is the Wacom Cintiq. It's a huge piece of equipment, weighs about 60 pounds, and it's fully adjustable. You can make it go up 90 degrees like a monitor, or have it hang down off of your desk like this. And the awesome thing about the Wacom Cintiq is it's essentially a monitor that you can draw directly on. The Wacom Cintiq picks up the pressure sensitivity and also even the tilt of the pen and rotation. So with a little practice, it literally becomes just like drawing on pencil or drawing on paper, with the advantages of a digital workflow. As a freelancer, this is something that was highly advantageous to me because I needed to work very quickly and often needed to do changes and revisions for the client, and working digitally helped that immeasurably. So let's make a little happy guy here. One other piece of equipment I use is the Razer Nostromo. It's a piece of equipment actually designed for video gamers, and what I like about it is that I can attach it here to my Wacom Cintiq and program the different keys with shortcuts. So for example, just with the flick of my thumb, I can quickly change the size of my brush, these buttons here, undo or redo, and I can also even rotate my screen the way you would rotate a piece of paper, so you can get a better angle. The computer I'm using is an iMac, a 27-inch. I find it's extremely valuable to have two monitors to work on, because I often have, as you can see here, some reference photos and imagery on the second screen, and I draw on this screen. And here you can also see I have a second window showing what I'm drawing in real time, which really helps me kind of, if I'm zoomed in on this screen, it helps me get an idea of how the entire composition works.
Okay, here's a quick warm-up sketch using the Wacom tablet and a program called Manga Studio 5. I'm using a brush that I created that kind of mimics pastels. This video here has been sped up about 4 times. I'm not normally this fast. The screen I'm drawing on is completely scratch resistant, and the pencil really kind of glides over it, which is fantastic. I use several pieces of software when illustrating the book, the most popular of which being Adobe Photoshop CS6. I also use Manga Studio 5 for painting and drawing, and Adobe Illustrator CS6 for the layout of the type. Choosing which Rehoboth Beach icons we would feature in the book was actually pretty difficult because we only had so much room. We went around town and made sure to collect as many good quality reference photos as we could because we really wanted to capture the details of each of the icons. One tool that proved to be very useful at gathering reference photos was Google Maps, because you could actually get a street view of Rehoboth Avenue. Here you can take a little 3D virtual walk down the street and do a 360 view of icons like the bandstand, which really helped us get a feel for how these things were constructed from all angles. The next step was designing a logo for our company. Keith Allen created all of these cool concepts in Adobe Illustrator. The one we picked was the fish logo. The Next, Joanne DeFiore came up with these character sketches based on many attributes from our own family. I sat down and drew up a series of very rough sketches to get an idea of how each page would look. At this stage, the idea was to just get ideas down on paper, so I worked very quickly and just blocked in basic elements. Here you can see me doing a little bit of sketch work using the Rehoboth Beach Water Tower as reference. After we discussed the sketches, Keith sat down with them and spent countless hours conceptualizing and engineering the mechanics of the pop-ups. Now that Keith has designed and engineered the actual pop-up mechanics of the book, I can now start going in and creating the actual artwork. The first stage for me is always doing a really rough and quick pencil drawing on top of the sketch. So you can see me here, I've already started about half of Rehoboth Avenue, and I'm just sort of further developing certain areas of the sketch. This stage here is still meant to be pretty rough, because later I will apply more finished line art on top of it. But this stage is very important because it sort of gives the whole team an idea of where I'm headed and gives me a foundation to build upon. Once I've showed the team my pencil sketches and we make any necessary changes, I then go in and reduce the opacity on the sketches, change it to blue so I can draw over top of it on a separate layer. At this stage, I'm looking to make the line art more finalized, so I take care to make things straight, fix any errors that I had in the pencil stage. You can see that I have two windows open. The second window is to sort of give me an idea of my entire composition, akin to stepping back from your canvas and taking a look at the piece as a whole. Right now, I think I'm using a pencil tool or an inking brush. And here's the final line art for the Rehoboth Avenue spread. The final stage, coloring, is also the most important. This is where I'll go in and add all of the depth and shading. The first step is I turn down my line art, and underneath it, I'll block in all of the major shapes. I've already done that here on this layer. This will allow me to very quickly make selections that I can later color in. And I'll show you that here. Right now I'm going to color in the roof of Browse About Books using a pastel brush that I created. So here, while I'm doing this, I can select the roof and not worry about coloring outside the lines, so to speak, because I've already blocked in those shapes. And essentially, I'll just do this, move around the canvas and put in colors and put in textures where they're needed. I can pull from colors elsewhere on the canvas to try and keep the color scheme consistent. Here we are adding some highlights. Watching this, I really want a Nicoboli right about now. All right, and as you can see, I'll show you here, one of the major challenges of illustrating for a pop-up book is that every object that pops out has to be on its own separate layer, and it has to be illustrated in its entirety. In this case here, I illustrated all of the people on a separate layer. This just made it easier for me to sort of, instead of painting around them, I can paint underneath the people. It makes things like adding their drop shadows much easier. And here, this is what I was talking about with the Suri. You can see that each piece is actually on its own layer. So each person had to be illustrated individually, which was quite a challenge. When we were just about finished, my grandmother, Joanne D. Fior, created this beautiful hand-drawn calligraphy. We imported it into Adobe Illustrator, and then we were able to copy and paste it into Photoshop, where we could put it directly onto the cover. You'll see me here adjusting it and adding a couple effects. I personally think it really brought the whole cover together and sort of made it something pretty unique. And finally, once all of my illustrations were complete, Keith Allen took them into Adobe Illustrator and did final touches and final mock-ups to make sure everything worked just right. And we were ready. We sent it off for print. All three of us were working on this book for over a year. So when we finally got this book and were able to hold it in our hands, it was just so exciting, and we are just so proud and thrilled with this book. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you at the beach. Poppy.